Hello everyone, this is the lecture number 26 of the lecture series of Naval Architecture made for MEO examination. In this lecture, we will continue with the transverse stability of the ship. Specifically, I am going to cover a topic, calculation of final center of gravity after the loading, unloading and the shifting the cargo within the ship. This is the third lecture of this topic. In earlier lecture, we have seen the theory behind how to calculate the center of gravity after the loading and unloading or shifting the cargo. We have seen the importance of this whole thing in earlier two lectures. In today's lecture, we are going to do the calculation to find out the new center of gravity after the loading, unloading and the shifting the cargo within the ship. Let's start the discussion on this. How to calculate the new center of gravity when you are loading and unloading the cargo simultaneously. For example, consider that there is one ship. I am looking in the transverse view. The total weight of the ship is a capital W and the location of the center of gravity from the keel is kg. So through the center of gravity the total weight is going to act. Now when you are going to add the cargo, when you are going to discharge a cargo from some places, specifically I am discussing now, I am adding or discharging the cargo from the center line only, as this is the first numerical. In upcoming numerical we will see that you can remove the cargo, you can add the cargo from the port side or the starboard side. But as this is the first numerical, I am going to add the cargo as well as remove the cargo from the center line only for the simplicity purpose. Now in this case, I am adding a cargo W1 at the location G1. It is a small G1 and the location of this center of gravity G1 from the keel, that distance I will call as a KG1. There is one more cargo, that is I am removing from the center line. The location is a small G2. The distance of this removal of the mass from the keel is KG2. Now what we have to do, after doing this all the operations, I want to find out where will be the new center of gravity will go. Whether it will come down the earlier center of gravity, whether it will go up to the earlier center of gravity, that we have to do here. Let's assume that the center of gravity is go above the old center of gravity somewhere here, that is a G1. So what we have to do, we have to calculate the location of this center of gravity from the keel. It means that you have to calculate KG1. Then how to start the calculation for this? Now if you see the ship in a transverse view, you will find that this all the weights are passing through the keel and that forces or the weight are not going to generate any movement. Then how we are going to calculate the new center of gravity? If you remember what we have seen in the earlier class, whenever you are finding a new center of gravity like a GG1, that time we have taken the movement generated because of the addition or removal of the weight from the center of gravity G divided by the final mass, divided by the final mass. This calculation we have done earlier. Then if I ask that find out the KG1 by using the same method, how you will calculate? You need to calculate the movement generated because of the weight which is added, the weight which is removed. Now I am asking, I don't want a GG1. I don't want a GG1. I want a KG1. What is the meaning of this? I am going to take the moment about the keel. If you remember that in the earlier example which we have taken about the bar, That time what we have done, we have taken the moment about the fulcrum, and the fulcrum was there at the center of gravity only. So when you are taking the moment about the G, when you are taking the moment about the fulcrum, the new center of gravity location will be measured from the fulcrum, or it is measured from the old center of gravity, that is GG1. So this is depends on about which point you are taking the moment. Now in this case, if you see, in this case I am asking find out the new center of gravity location from the keel. It means that I am going to take the moment about the keel. So we have to calculate the moment about the keel because of addition and the removal of the mass. But if you see on the screen that all the mass, all the weight which is added or which is removed, all are in the center line. So what do you think, that where is the perpendicular distance here? There is no perpendicular distance if you see the figure. Then on what basis I am asking that you can calculate the kg1 and then find out the moment because of the addition removal of the weight? How you are going to calculate the moment? It means that mathematics may be fail here. But it's not like that. If you see the physically, whenever you are adding the weight at the top, whenever you remove the weight at the bottom of the old center of gravity, there will be a shift of the center of gravity along the center line of the ship. Physically it is there. There will be a change of the center of gravity, but if you see the mathematically, it is showing the error. How you are going to solve this problem? Only for the analysis purpose, only for solving this numerical, what we are going to do? We are going to keep this ship in this horizontal manner. You can see the look, the position 2. This is the position 1, the actual position, and this is the position 2. Though only for the analysis purpose. Now what you are going to do now? Now you can take the moment about the keel because of this all the three lobes here. Now W1 is added in the ship. So I am taking the arrow downward for the addition. The weight of the ship is obviously it is adding in the ship. So that will be also in a downward. And W1 it is a removed from the ship. So I am taking upward arrow. The location of the center of gravity of the whole ship is a kg. Location of the center of gravity of the small w1, that is kg1, and the location of the center of gravity of w2, that is kg2. Now you can use this formula for the calculation of a new kg. Kg1 is equal to capital W into the perpendicular distance from the keel to the location of the center of gravity, that is kg, plus W1 into the location of the addition of the weight from the keel, that is a kg1. Now this W2 is removed. For the removing the weight, I am going to use the sign as a minus, minus W2 into kg2. Divided by the final mass. The final mass will be capital W plus small W1 minus small W2. So like this you can calculate the new center of gravity location from the keel. I am repeating once again, the first letter of this, it means you are taking the moment about this point. In this case, I am taking a moment about the keel. In earlier numerical or earlier discussion, we have used the notation, that is a GG1. It means that in that case, I was taking the moment about the center of gravity. So we will get the new center of gravity location from the G only. So it will be GG1. But someone says that sir, no, I don't want the location of the new center of gravity from the keel. I want the new center of gravity location from the old center of gravity only. It means that we need to take the movement about the old center of gravity only. So you should know the location of each weight from the old center of gravity. Let's consider here the W1 which is added. So from the old center of gravity to the small g1, let's consider the distance is a d1. Then there is one weight, that is a W2, which is removed. So I should know the distance between the old center of gravity to the location g2, that is a d2. So these two distances I should know, then only I can do the calculations. So what I am going to do now, I will take the moment about the g. Then how to take the moment about the g? Now there are three weights here. The first weight is the weight of the ship, that is capital W, into. Now you are taking the moment about g through which the total weight of the ship is acting. So there is no perpendicular distance here. So W into 0, it will come like this, plus small W1 into D1 minus. Now here one more thing you have to keep in your mind. For the lever, means perpendicular distance, also you have to take the sign. Like for the addition of the cargo, we have taken the sign as a positive. For the removal of the cargo, we have taken the sign as a negative. Likewise, here if you see that the weight W1 is there on the right side of the old center of gravity, and W2 which is removing, that is from left side of the center of gravity. Both are in the opposite direction of the reference point, that is the center of gravity. So in this case, what we have to do, the lever or the perpendicular which we are taking now, for that also we have to take some sign. So what I am going to do now, I will take for D1, I will take as a positive sign, and for D2 I will take a negative sign because it is in the opposite direction. So I will write like this, plus only, minus. Now for the removal of the weight, I will take a minus W2. For the lever, I will take again minus sign, divided by total weight W plus W1 minus W2. Like this, you have to do the calculation and you have to find out the location of a GG1. Now in earlier case, we got the location of the new center of gravity from the keel. In this case, we got the location of the new center of gravity from the capital G. In both the cases, whatever the answers will come, both are same only. But I will suggest to everyone, always take the moment about the keel. The reason is simple. Why I am saying this? If you see, if you are taking the moment about the center of gravity, we have seen that we have to consider the two different types of the sign conventions. For the loading and unloading the cargo, we have to take the plus and minus sign. And at the same time, for the lever also, you have to take the plus and minus sign. Because the weights are there on either side of the old center of gravity, that is capital G. But if you take the moment about the keel, if you see, whatever the loading and unloading is done, that will be towards only one side of the keel. So for the lever, there is no need to take the signs. There is no plus and minus sign. All the levers, all the perpendicular distance are a plus only. So that is the very good advantage if you are taking the moment about the keel. So I will suggest that always take the moment about the keel and find out the location of the new center of gravity from the keel only. In upcoming classes, I am going to use this formula, that is a KG1. I am going to take the moment about the keel only. I hope all of you understood this methodology, how to proceed for calculation of the vertical shift of the center of gravity from the keel, that is called as a KG1. Let's take one numerical. You can easily understand whatever things I have discussed just now. So in this numerical, you can see a ship of a 6000 tons displacement, that is equal to the weight of the ship, has a kg 6 meter. It means that they have given the old center of gravity, or you can say the initial center of gravity of the ship from the keel. Then km is 7.33 meter, distance of a meta center from the keel. The following cargo is a loaded. So these are the three cargo which we have loaded. So 1000 tons which is loaded, and the location of that 1000 tons load is given, that is a kg 2.5 meter. So location of that cargo is given from the keel, it is a 2.5 meter. The second one is a 500 tons we have loaded. The location of that cargo from the keel is a 3.5 meter. The third one is 750 tons of the cargo is loaded again, and the location of that cargo from the keel is given 9 meter. Some of the cargo we have discharged, that is 450 tons of the cargo is discharged from the location of a 0.6, and second one is 800 tons of the cargo is discharged from the location 3 meter above the keel. They are asking find the final GM. So before starting this numerical, I will always recommend that you have to draw the diagram of a transverse view of the ship and show all the loads, so it will be easy to understand where the center of gravity will lie after the loading and the discharging the cargo. Let's draw the diagram first. So we have a ship in a transverse view, and there are some loads we have added, or you can say loaded, and some of the cargoes we have discharged. So you can see the whole center of gravity of the ship is from the keel to the 6 meter, and through this center of gravity the weight of the ship is going to act, that is 6000 tons, and the km of the ship is, you can see, 7.33 meter. Then cargo is loaded, 1000 tons is loaded at the kg 2.5 meter, 500 tons of the cargo is loaded at the location 3.5 meter from the keel, 750 tons of the cargo is loaded at the location 9 meter from the keel, 450 tons of the cargo is discharged at the location 0.6 from the keel, and 800 tons of the cargo discharged location 3 meter from the keel. So for the loading of the cargo we have shown the downward arrow, and for the discharge we have shown the upward arrow. Now how to proceed for this? Again we have to take the moment about the keel only. So I will suggest all of you, whenever you are going to solve this type of a numerical and where you have a lot of the loads, now in this case only we have taken the 5 to 6 loads are there, there might be chances that you may get more than 5 to 6 loads. So at that time the way of a traditional writing the formula, that is not good. So I will suggest that there might be chances that you make some mistake in that calculation. So I will suggest that all of you please create one table, and in that table you have to write this all the given values, and you have to solve the numerical. So how to proceed for that? I will suggest all of you, once you draw the diagram, whenever you are going to solve the numerical, always create a table where the first column is a weight, the second column is a lever, that is a perpendicular distance from the keel, and the third column is a moment. Again I am taking the moment about the keel. Whatever the weight you are adding or removing, you have to take the distance from the keel to that location. Okay, so in the numerical also you will get all the location from the keel only. So the first thing you can see the plus, the sign, again I am using the plus sign for the loading the cargo and minus sign for the unloading the cargo or discharging the cargo. So first four things are there, that is a 6000 that is the weight of the ship. Obviously, it is the adding the weight. So 6,000 tons. What is the center of gravity location of the ship from the keel? That is a 6 meter, which is given to us. Then 1,000 tons of the cargo we have loaded. So it will be a plus sign. The location of the center of gravity from the keel, it is a 2.5 meter. Then 500 tons of the cargo, again it is a loaded. The location of the center of gravity of 500 tons of the cargo is a 3.5 meter from the keel. Then 750 tons of the cargo is added. The location of the center of gravity from the keel is a 9 meter. Then there are two cargoes which we have discharged. So that's the reason we have taken the sign as a minus. Minus 450, the location of the center of gravity of that cargo from the keel is 0.6 meter. Then minus 800 tons, because again it is a discharging, the location of this load is a 3 meter above the keel. So once you know this both the column, then third column you have to generate, that is a column number 1 multiplied by column number 2. It means that you are taking the movement about the keel. So these are the all the numbers are going to generate. Then at the end, do the algebraic summation of the column number 3, that is a column of a movement. Then algebraic summation of the weight that you have to do. Finally, when you want to find out the new center of gravity location from the keel, that will be kg1 is equal to summation of the movement divided by summation of a weight. Substitute both the values here. You will get the final answer is a 6.33 meter. Now if you want to locate this new center of gravity in the given figure, you can see here the old center of gravity from the keel is at the 6 meter. Obviously the new center of gravity will be above that, because the new center of gravity location is a 6.33. So it will be somewhere here. So that I have shown here, you can see from the keel to that G1 the distance is 6.33. Now our task is to find out the GM value, new metacentric height value. So now the new metacentric height will be from the G1 to M. G1 to M, if you want to calculate that, G1M is equal to, G1M is equal to KM, keel to metacenter, this distance is given to us, KM minus KG1, which is just now we got. So KM value is 7.33, which is given to us, and that will be fixed after the loading and unloading the ship. Minus 6.33, it will become a 1 meter. So you can see here from G1 to M, the metacentric height is a 1 meter. So let's start the second numerical. That is, a ship of 4000 tons displacement, it means that the weight of the ship is of 4000 tons, has its center of gravity 1.5 meter aft of the midship. So this is the profile view of the ship, and this is the center of gravity location of the ship G. And they have given the center of gravity location of the ship 1.5 meter aft of the midship, means this location is given to us, that is 1.5 meter. This line is corresponding to the midship, and 4 meter above the keel. From the keel it is at 4 meter. Now 200 tons of the cargo are now added 45 meter forward of the midship. So this is the location of the midship. From here to this location, the 45 meter is there, where we are adding a cargo of 200 tons and 12 meter above the keel. 12 meter above the keel. So the location of the cargo is given, that is 45 meter ahead of the midship section and 12 meter above the keel. Now they are asking, calculate the new position of the center of gravity and the angle in which the center of gravity moves relative to the horizontal. Now what is the difference between the earlier numerical and this numerical? In the earlier numerical, the data which is given to us, that everything you can see in the transverse view of the ship, and whatever the loading and unloading is done in the ship, that is only on the center line of the ship. But in this numerical, whatever the data is given to us, on the basis of data, you will come to know that the data is related to the profile view of the ship. So you can see we have drawn one ship in a profile view, and there is a one cargo which is added at the forward of the ship, and the location of the cargo is given to us. Now if you remember the earlier classes, we have seen that if you add the cargo, then how the center of gravity position will change because of the addition of the cargo. So to calculate that location, again I am taking just a random location. So this is the old center of gravity G, and this is the location where you are adding the cargo. Let's call it the location is a small g. Now if I ask where will be the movement of the new center of gravity, to find out that you have to draw a one straight line from the capital G to the small g. So new center of gravity will be on this line only, somewhere here. Let me call that is a G1. Now they are asking find out the position of the new center of gravity. This is the first sub question, and the second sub question is they are asking find out how much is the angle made by the center of gravity line with the horizontal. They are asking this angle. So there will be one triangle you can generate like this. This is a G, G1, and you have to find out this angle. So to calculate this angle, you should know this vertical distance and you should know this horizontal distance. If you know this by using the formula tan theta is equal to opposite side, that is called as A, and the adjacent side called as a B. So tan theta is equal to A by B. If you do, you will get the value of a theta. Like this you have to solve the numerical. If you observe here, new center of gravity is moving in inclined direction. It means that it is not in the horizontal direction or it is not in a vertical direction. It is going in inclined direction. It means that it will have two components here. If I ask where is the new center of gravity, then you have to give the both the coordinates. X coordinate, it means that horizontal coordinates as well as the vertical coordinates. So in this numerical, we have to do the calculation twice. It means that you have to find out the horizontal location of the new center of gravity from the old center of gravity, and vertical location of the new center of gravity from the keel. So let's start the discussion on this. So first of all, we will find the vertical shift of the center of gravity. Again, we are going to take the moment about the keel. So you will get the kg1 value from the keel to this g1, this vertical distance you will get whenever you are finding the vertical shift of the center of gravity. Let me call here kg1. So for this purpose, how to proceed? I will again suggest you always create a table like this. The first column is a weight, second column is a lever, and the third column is a moment. So here the first weight, that is a 4000 tons, that is a weight of the ship, and 200 tons is a load, the cargo which is a loader here. The vertical location of the center of gravity from the keel is a 4 meter, and the cargo which is a loader 200 tons, the vertical location of the center of gravity from the keel is a 12 meter. So third column is a taking the moment about the keel. So you multiply 4000 multiply by 4, you will get a 16,000. The second one is a 200 multiplied by 12, you will get a 2400. Do the algebraic summation of the moment, you will get the summation is a 18,400. And the algebraic summation of the weight is 4200. So if you want to find out the vertical shift of the kg, you can write like this: kg1 is equal to the algebraic summation of the moment divided by algebraic summation of the weight, that is the final mass of the ship after the loading the cargo. You will get a 4.38 meter. So you can see here from the keel to the new center of gravity vertical distance is a 4.38 meter. Likewise, I want to find out the horizontal shift of the center of gravity, that is a G1, from the old center of gravity G. So what I am going to do now, I will take the moment about the G. So for that purpose, again we need to create this table. The first column is a weight, second is a lever, third is a moment. The first weight is, that is a weight of the ship, 4000. Now what is the lever here? Lever will be 0. Why? Because this 4000 tons of the cargo is passing through the center of gravity of the ship about which we are taking the movement. So there won't be any lever here. It means that the weight of the ship is not going to generate any movement above the center of gravity, that is a 0 only. Now 200 tons of the cargo is added forward of the midship. The distance from the forward of the midship, it is given 55 meter. But we need the distance from the old center of gravity to the weight which is added. So it will be 55 plus 1.5 meter. It will be 56.5 meter. So if you take the movement 200 multiplied by 46.5, it will be 9300. So take the algebraic summation of the movement, algebraic summation of the weight, you will get the new center of gravity location from the G. Again, this is the horizontal shift of the G1. It will be 2.2142 meter from the old center of gravity horizontally. So if you draw both the magnitudes in the diagram, you can see here, this is a 2.21, and from the keel to here it is a 4.38. But what I want now, I want how much angle made by the center of gravity, the G1, with the horizontal. For that purpose, I need to measure, I need to see this triangle here, and this triangle I have drawn here. So the horizontal distance from G to here, it is a 2.21, but what about this value? This value, just now we have calculated the KG1. We have calculated the KG1, it is came 4.38. But from the keel to the center of gravity for up to here, this distance is known to us, that is a 4 meter. So 4.38 minus 4, if you do, you will get a 0.38, that will be a this vertical distance that I have shown here, 0.38. So I want to calculate this theta. So you can use here tan theta is equal to opposite side by adjacent side. So you will get the value of a theta is 9°45". So this is the answer for the second sub question. The angle in which the center of gravity moves relative to the horizontal, that is 9°45". I hope all of you understood this numerical. If you are visiting my channel first time, please like, share and subscribe. Thank you very much for listening.